QuadJacks TV, and I'm sitting down once again with Mr. Parkinson, whose name I still cannot pronounce correctly.
Well, I've got an awful lot less money now, so you can call me anything you like.
I can call. I'm tempted to say Padraig, like Patrick, but more of it with more of a G instead of a TR.
Yeah, yeah, you can get on with that. But I want to talk about All American Dave.
Let's talk about All American Dave. I hear it's on your mind.
Yeah, it is on my mind. I mean, you know, people keep talking about tells.
Yes.
And you know, it's like you know, you got the NFL guys are getting into all sorts of trouble with taping guys and trying to work out what the hell is going on, everybody might. But at this World Series, the biggest tell of all time is if All-American Dave delivers your food.
The biggest tell of all time?
Yes.
Ah, I didn't think about that. Go on.
But, you know, it's, you know, the most stupid thing you can do, probably playing poker, is have headphones on and have your iPad and the whole lot. I'm not even going to go into the cheating concept. But, you know, poker is probably the most amazing game you can play, where people will actually tell you what the whole game plan is. And, you know, it goes on to all sorts of levels. But the biggest tell of all time is if All-American Dave delivers your food.
How so? What does it tell?
Well, it means the guy's important, it probably means he's got money. I mean, like, you have to have a whole load of money, like, if you're going to be paying twice what you pay anywhere else for food. But, I mean, I think it's fantastic. Like, I mean, you know, a guy, All-American Dave, and I'm sure it's all great stuff.
Delicious.
But, you know, a guy, some beautiful-looking girl with tattoos and a whole lot comes in, and she delivers food to you. So, what are you going to do? Like, I mean, like, if you're a professional poker player, you're going to lose every fucking ounce of strategy. Like, have you seen these guys get these meals? Like All-American Dave delivers the meal. And then the guy looks around the place to see who's looking at him. Because he's obviously hugely important. If All-American Dave was giving them the food.
Right.
Like, it doesn't matter if it looks like shit. I mean, like, have you seen this food?
Yes, I've seen it and I've eaten it as well.
Okay, well, I'm sorry about that. Well, I'm not saying that All-American Dave's food isn't fantastic. I'm just saying that it's the biggest tell in poker, the guys that are getting it. I mean, like, how dumb is that?
How dumb is that?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I know that these guys are hungry and they want to eat good food and he does something nice for these guys. But I think I understand what you mean. I thought you meant that it's almost looked upon as a status symbol. Like, look at me.
But it is a status symbol. I mean, you're getting delivered food from All-American
right.
David. I mean, like, you're not an ordinary poker player. You're obviously somebody hugely famous.
Ordinary poker players eat in the poker kitchen, right? Or they go to the bar.
Boy, I wouldn't recommend all of that, but I mean, but you know, like, if your problem is you have to be seen to get an All-American deal,
sure,
Dave, and then look all around the place,
look around
just to
the
see
place.
Who's looking at you.
I love how you mimicked it too, you know.
Like, that's what they do. Then, you know, like, if you're playing a tournament against these guys, like we're playing for huge money
right.
here. We're playing for huge money and I lost. But, you know, if you were at a table just trying to work out, I mean, who's what? The All-American Dave guy would just...
So that annoys you a little bit. Sorry, I never really have a good idea whether you're finished speaking or not, so I'm sorry to interrupt you if that's what I just did.
No, it doesn't annoy me at all. I think it's hilarious. I mean, like a really good player will identify himself. Like, I mean, you know, he could be sitting there, you know the way poker works, and you're trying to work out what the hell. You know, it's not like the old days when you play poker, because... half the time, like, you used to know, like, three guys at the table, and you're trying to work out who the other guys are. all of a sudden some guy's got an All-American team. Thinks that, well, obviously he's a good player.
Right.
First of all, he can afford All-American Dave's prices.
Right.
But secondly, he thinks he's good enough that that he can look around at everybody and be an All-American Dave guy.
So I think I understand what you mean, certainly.
So, do you eat that stuff? Well, there you go. But I'm sorry about
yes,
that.
Yes, exactly. Mike?
Well, you know, stuff happens, but you know,
it is right. Pretty yeah. Awesome, yeah. Bet you wish you had this All-American Dave meal, huh?
Yeah, always.
Yes. All right, you can move along now. Thank you. You fulfilled your part perfectly, Mr. Parkinson. I've really enjoyed listening to you speak your mind. Shall we not do this again sometime?
Yeah, we should. Absolutely. I'm going to be eating something different. I mean, you know. I'd be quite happy eating sushi or sashimi or I wouldn't want it delivered to me at the table.
Still on the All-American Dave.
A little bit, yeah. It's not like that, you know.
This really annoys you.
No, I love it. I think it's fantastic. But I think poker players, I mean, you know, sometimes guys have so much into themselves that they really forget how to play the game. And I think this is maybe a move from the online game to the live game. You know, like I know geniuses who play live poker and they never identify themselves, except maybe in a pot you played against them.
Right.
But the online guys, I mean, look, I'll be very serious. I think I'm right here. They want to identify themselves as what they are.
Right. That's what you've noticed.
Yeah, but like, it's the biggest talent poker.
Your observations are precious, and I take them very seriously, and I'm very happy to listen to them anytime. Mr. Parkinson, P. Where are you off to after this?
I think there's a party poker party on.
I think so as well. I've seen a couple of people tweet about it. But you're with 888.
I'm with 888, but I think I'm going to go and play in, where was it? Cairns? Then Australia. I've never been in Australia in my life.
No?
No, but I'm going to go and play there.
Well, listen, I hope you have a good time at the party.
Well, probably a better time at the party.
I'll bet you'll want to look cool at the party, won't you?
What, you got a problem with the way I'm dressed?
No, I think it's fine. I just think you should roll in.
Okay.
Okay?
Have you seen Robert Williamson? I mean, he said that Dave had him playing tennis. I mean, I think this guy, All-American Dave, was super cool. But can you imagine trying to get Robert Williamson playing tennis? Like, I mean, you know, there does come a line in where we just have to... I don't care whether he believes it, whether they believe it.
I wish you'd done this whole rant holding the All-American Dave meal. Why not? Please, you're going to take this with you. We are now going to watch you get up and walk away with the meal. So thank you for talking to us, Mr. Parkinson. Enjoy the All-American Dave meal and enjoy the party.
Okay, I'd like to apologize to you and all the American Dave. I'm sure it's great. I'd also like to apologize to Robert Williamson and... Barack Obama.
I did not think there would be an apology corner in this interview, but okay.
Okay, well, I'm not going to do that then.
No, I don't think you have to. Just walk away with your meal. Yeah, you can leave your drink here. Trade you. Drink for the meal. All right.
I'll have to drink it, that's okay.
All right, that's fine. Padraig, I'm going to say it the way I want to. Padraig Parkinson, thank you so much for speaking to us, sir. Talk to you again soon.
Well, I'd like to think so. Are you happy with that?
I don't know what else to say. I thought we were supposed to cut this.